Okay, here's some beef that I canned last night. I just pulled out a pressure cooker this morning, cleaned them up and marked them. But I had some questions asked to me on my YouTube video. Why should I can beef versus freezing? Well, let me give you a couple of different reasons for me anyway. I used to do a lot of canning beef, or a lot of freezing beef. And, you know, you got freezer, I've got an expensive $400 vacuum sealer here, but I still don't care. You got a thin piece of plastic that you're vacuum sealing, and even after a year, you're going to start getting some kind of freezer burn, or it doesn't come out right. And it's not meal ready. This is what I like about it. You know, if you lose power, if things go down, you don't have electricity or something, you can always move all your canned goods into a room that you can heat, or you're going to be in anyway. And there's some added benefits. Like, for instance, okay, I can some chuck, and there's some marbling in it, you're going to get some fat. The beautiful thing about canning this, and I put a little beef base on top here, Better Than Bouillon beef base, which is a really good restaurant quality beef base, and it makes that phenomenal odd juice in it. But what I do, now you can open this, okay, and you can just take a little spoon and take the fat right off. The rest is pure solid meat. Pure solid meat. I mean, it's great. You don't get that with freezing. And another thing. Okay, I wanted a hot beef last night. I brought this in the house. My grandson, he grabbed it and started tasting it. And just about, I was going to have to go out and get another one because he said, man, this grandpa, this is wild. This is awesome. You know, I can make sandwiches. I can do it. He was eating it cold right out of the jar. It was great. And it is. Okay, so I took it and I just took a little butter and put it in the frying pan and browned it a little bit and put a flour and made a roux, and then I poured the juice from this in and just a little additional water and made a gravy. Oh, and some mashed potatoes real quick, and I made myself a hot beef. Well, if you wanted beef or noodles or stroganoff, or if you want to make a dual pulled beef, make this and heat it up and put barbecue sauce on it or mix it with barbecue sauce. There's just a whole bunch of, you want to make some vegetable beef soup, and you just want to make a small batch. You don't, just for you. You can just mix up, you can buy the diced up tomatoes with the green chilies and a whole shot. You can throw that in, a couple things, and carrots, and this, and just make a small little batch of beef stew for yourself, throw in a crock pot, or a little pan, and instant. What I like about it is canning beef, and not only this, I'm going to also take some hamburger and fry it, taco seasoning it, and then can it. And then when you want tacos, you take a jar out, pop it open, throw it in a bowl, hit it in the microwave, grab your taco shells and your lettuce and tomatoes and onions out. By the time it's warmed up, you're eating tacos right now. You know, frying pans, no mess, no hassle. You know, it's, you know, try it. Get yourself a canner. Look on Craigslist, look around, even put an ad on Craigslist, looking for canner. A lot of people, have canners sitting around. You know, they've lost and forgot how great it is. And storage, I mean, I've read many times that a well-preserved jar of canned goods will last virtually forever. I know they found jars way back from Napoleonic time that they opened up and ate and found out was good. It preserves it for so long a time. You might, after 4, 5, 6 years, lose some quality and stuff. But you're not going to get the freezer burn and stuff like that. I know a lot of guys can venison. We've canned venison. Oh, my gosh. And you know the deer tallow. Nobody wants to eat the deer. That's the beautiful thing. The fat rises to the top, skim it off, and you got pure meat. I know. I was turned on to this by my brother, Steve. We're out ice fishing, and he brings in a couple cans of something, jars of something, and a loaf of bread. And I said, what are you doing? He said, watch. And it was venison, canned venison. And he threw it on the fish house stove and heated it up and made some sandwiches. I said, oh my God, what is this? This is awesome. He said, it's canned venison. Well, it improves the flavor so good. Anyway, this is just a little update. I wanted to just clear that up, why I think canning is better than freezing. You know, I mean, sure, you're going to freeze some steaks and stuff like that. But man, there are so many benefits to having some canned stuff and soups and everything too. So give it a whirl. Try it for yourself. Borrow somebody's canner if you have to. You know, a grandma, uncle, man, somebody's got a canner. If you just want to try it out, borrow their canner from them. or get together with two or three people and do some canning. Anyway, this is Larry up in Brainerd. Ciao.